71st birthday. I want to be able to share some things tonight for all my very close friends and people I've trained and people I've learned from. I got a lot of shout outs from some really nice people. My friends in Louisiana, Master Kyle Reed, Master Clyde Stanley, thank you so much. Grandmaster Al Garza, Virginia, Grandmaster Rick Moneymaker, Tom, so many, many nice people I've been able to work with and learn from and teach as well, so it's really neat. So tonight I want to share this with you. I have Master Schaefer with me, some of my own people. So, and there's some new people in this class as well as some of my regulars, but we're going to go over some basic fundamentals of Sun Tzu, the leverages. Let's talk about the concept. What we're talking about is footwork, level change, shorten the move, and stationary movement. And then lock and load, and then adapt to what fits you, okay? So we're going to start by, Tab's going to film me from this angle with you guys behind me. And we're going to start with basic footwork, which is what we all learned when we first start. And that's forward, back, side, pivot, switch step. So that's your movement. The number one thing I do, no matter whether I'm punching, striking, or someone grabs me, there has to be leg movement. For instance, Connor over here, thank you. Let's say Connor grabbed me by the throat. Well, there's a lot of cool things I can do here, but actually there's a bridge right now. He's very strong because I'm stationary. He can lean against me. I'm holding him up. So either I have to make his feet move, which is probably unlikely since he's bigger and stronger, so I've got to make him move. During that transition of movement gives me the opportunity to use my technique. The technique I use doesn't really matter. Everybody's caught up on what styles are best, but the fighter's best styles are just tools. I adapted to the tools that I've learned from the arts that I like, and I've also studied 9 different martial arts, belts in 5 of them, and black belts, but really it comes down to just learning how to adapt and use your movement. So, number one thing I want to start with is just by movement. I'm going to start with a basic wrist lock. You're going to straight grab. Now, first thing, hold me tight. I can't move him. I can't move him at all. Now, the minute I step, look at the second he moved. Now I can start to do my technique. And if technique is going to vary based on system and style you're in. You know what I mean? If it works, don't need to change it. If it's not working, look at some of the concepts I'm showing you. You might be missing one of these things. The number one problem with most wrist locks is people don't understand. The person has to commit. Okay? Once he commits, I have to be able to move his center. If I can't move his center, nothing's going to work. Now, once I move the center, I need level change. Right here, he's regrouped. He's very strong. Wow. Now he's below his center. So wherever I move, I'm going to be able to do something successful. So which one I'm going to do here? I'm going to go 1. See how I moved offline? Now notice I brought this up and look at my elbows, how nice and tight they are. I'm just doing the inside wrist lock. It's nice and tight. I'm not out here. Now there's systems that do that and they know how to line it up and they can make it work. If it's working, don't worry about it. But how you know if something really works is if you do it against other systems. It may work in your house, but it may not work in other houses. That's why that cross training is so important. Just grabbing here, I'm stepping back, boom, there's my lock right here. Now, I gotta lock it. I gotta lock it before I load it. Lock it means it won't go any further without causing movement. This is a wrist hold. Nothing's locked. Now it's locked. Now, by changing angles, I can make something happen. Watch me again. 1. I have down here's my level here. Now, watch me again do this footwork. Forward, back, side, pivot, switch step, right? Now let's take that first move and step back and step forward. Wow. If I want him to go back here, instead of turning and dragging him, I just step back. If I want to go over here, I just, oh wow. Once he's locked and loaded, wherever I go, I go down, he goes down. You see? So a lot of people make it very difficult because they become arm players. It's cool, but it's, in my opinion, BS. Bad stuff. Okay? All right, so here, 1. Wow, I want him to go down. I have to drop my energy down. There you go. I don't have to do all that. Okay, I can, but I don't need to. If I want him to go behind me, I just step back. If I want him to go over here, wow. You see? Now he's so tall, I'm almost level two and he's still upright. So I have to go to level three because of the difference in size here. So level three, he's going down. You see what I mean? All right, now, I want you to watch this. Forward, back, left, right, pivot. Now, I want to show you how to do that stationary, because here's the magic. Hopefully you see when I do something really good that I do it with less. I remember when I first learned this, it was like this. Eventually it fell. But meanwhile, I get some guys that are real flexible. Man, he won't go down. And then I met Professor Wally J. And Wally goes, oh, no, oh, why work so hard? I said, wow, light came on. What he did, he shortened the movement. Now he calls his system small circle jiu-jitsu. That was his concept. So, now this, the footwork I just showed you, I'm going to do it stationary. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 4, back, 2, 3 to the side, 4 to the side, up, down. Now, when this is locked, oh, wow. You see that? Now, that's called stationary movement. This is the magic when you start to really get good. When I do a movement, oh, I lock, I feel it. I had to adjust it. If you ever worked on a, you put a nut on a screw, okay? Sometimes you gotta adjust it until it catches the grooves. Most people learn something. It's not working, adjust it. You gotta lock it in. There it is. And that becomes a feel thing. And some people go lock. He's a real good hoogie. He locks real easy. Some others don't lock that good. So you gotta find that spot or maybe let it go. So here's our technique now. You grab it, step back. One, I'm here. You see? Now, all I wanna do, if I wanna take him straight down, I wanna take this into his body where he can't retreat. Now, by forcing this down, he's gonna go down. All right? Now, I'm gonna make a combat technique out of it. That was a takedown for self-defense. Combat, I want to break his wrist. I want to break it bad. I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, that's like great.
One. When I go to here, I step on his foot. He can't go anywhere. I break his hand. I guarantee I break it. That's Sun Tzu. If he grabbed me from here, first thing, what transfer, there it is, see? All I got to do is drop down to level two. There he is. Turn that around. Oh, wow, look at him. Wow. He's gonna come up to me. He's gonna come up. Then I got the thing to lock. Yeah. Back to gooseneck, pistol grip, chicken wing. Oh, back to rest. Oh, wow, everything is there. But all from this simple movement. One. Now I'm gonna take the slag out. Now I'm gonna pull his head up. Boom. Come back down. It's a knockout. Lift his head up. Come down with the shin. Do this easy when you do this. You bang right across the face. Okay. Now. You grab straight grab. Transfer. Oh wow, notice it's locked again. Look how the hand is locked. That's an inside wrist lock. I know one lock, I do a thousand ways. You've heard me say that many times. This hand. One, transfer over. I can change hands, nothing changes. I change my feet as well. See? I can go here. If he grabbed me from here, same move. Nothing has to change. Notice when he goes down, I keep the lock on. If I keep pushing, oh, I'm going to break. You see? Very, very simple. But very, very effective. People start out verbally. I'm going to kick your ass. Punch, kick, that's not working. Take that. But some of the dumb, sometimes they're dumb enough to walk up and go, you know who I am? Yeah, you're the guy who thinks to break the wrist. You know? Because they don't know. So, they grab one. Now, I can always add this little. Oh wow, perfect, all the other stuff, we're gonna take it down. But I got the mechanics right here to do anything I wanna do. The what? Oh, it's called basket weave. Up. Thank you. Stand up, putting up.
Back to it.
And then we start doing a flow drill. So what's transfer? One. Just like that. Whoa, bring him around. Wow. Now I'm going to lift up, push down as a choke. Okay. Now I want to get him up, bring him towards his feet. Wow, there's our flow. What a worst workout is this? Look at that. Wow, look at that. Now I can change my mind, go to here anytime, do something else if I want to. See? But I want that option. Now, you notice I said it up, adapt to what fits you. You grab your two hands. I just need the one. The other hand will come off by itself. Boom. Hand no longer feeling good. One more time. This time we grab it. Same thing. I want to go this way. Oh, wow. Wow. Let me grab it. Oh, wow. All right. Grab yourself a partner. Here's what we're going to start with. Cross grab, keep your eyes on him, step back, bring it in tight, look at this, just like this. Now all I want you to do is, see this? This is that stationary movement I was talking about. Instead of, watch. See that? Now because he's so long and flexible, I got to go level 3. Now if you're doing that to me, I'm not going to do it because I won't get back up. But he can do it from level 2.5 because he's got the height, you see what I mean? So once I'm here, boom. Then I can always let go, hit, do whatever I want to do. Right, back, come back around, boom, whatever I want to do, it's there. You see? And I want this, one. Whoa, there I am right there. And then lean in. This is the magic, right here. That's the magic. Not this. All right, 1, 2, 3. Just take your hand hold like this. Look where my thumb's going. Now watch how I bend the wrist. You see, that's locked. Actually, it's not locked, it's bent. It's very uncomfortable, but it's not locked yet because he has mobility to move it any way he wants to. Now it's locked. Now let's look at this angle. Let's look at the line here and the line of the shoulder. If his shoulder is straight up like this, I guarantee it's not locked. Here's the lock right there. When you take it out like this, you extend, you lose the lock. Now, if I take it far enough, he's eventually going to fall. He's going to be very unhappy and get back up, look really angry. Because he knew he was going to fall before he fell, so he prepared for it. So I don't want to come out here like this. I want to take all joints to him. Now, see this right here? This is a spout, I call it. Just like I'm pouring hot coffee. I'm going to pour the coffee. I'm going to pour the coffee on his foot, not mine. You see that? It's real hot coffee. I don't want it on my ass. And I'm pouring it on his foot. So think of that right there. So now, I'm here. There is a lot. Look at the pressure here. Now for combat, I hit. He's going to break. He's going to go down real fast. Let's say he was choking me. And I poke through to my elbow. Boom, it's going to break. Going to break. Palm press. Oh wow, it's going to be very dangerous. But even a palm press, I turn it where it locks. You see what I mean? And there again, he's very, very flexible. At least he will be flexible.
My God. Just this wrist.
Okay. So, watch again. One. Now I'm going to pour the coffee. Now if I really want to mess him up, I pour the coffee on this foot over here. Now let's watch the rotation. So if you want to put someone on their back, cross mark the leverage. This simply just takes him down here. He's prepared to kick me. He knows he's a martial artist. He knows he break fall. He's prepared to start fighting now. Maybe he's a really good jiu-jitsu ground fighter. He's in his world. He's playing, come on in. You see? So what I want to do here is, when I take this to here, touch me with the other hand. Touch me. You're going to do me any good. You know, because it's being taken away from you. Now, obviously, when we apply it, we do it very, very fast. I don't want you to do it right now. Come for a punch. You really think you can do that? I got some land to sell you. Although, well, I've seen other masters do it. Well, yeah, because we have someone who just don't know how to throw a punch. And there are lots of them out there. It will work. But I don't know you don't know how to throw a punch until I find out you can throw a punch. You understand? So basically, that's why people don't like wrist locks. Oh, it doesn't work. Well, it doesn't work for you because you don't know how to do it and understand the philosophy about it. But once he, let's say he blocks my hand and he grabs, that might send a lock. But he has to grab me before that's going to happen. Walking up and doing this, he's got to be asleep. You know, you shouldn't hurt him. He's tell him what you want. He'll write you a check. He's not too smart. Okay, so one, come in. I'm going to take it right across the body. Look how easy it is. Now, look how easy it is to throw him. He's a big guy. Now, once I can manipulate the arm like this, I'm going to use the arm as my weapon. He's very tight. He's strong until I bend this. Now watch. Boom, right in the groin of his arm. Ah! I'm going to call it the cart dude. Jacking with his own arm. You see? Now, let's look at the imagination we have here. One, two. Oh, it's a throw. It's bad. You know? Oh, I decide to go other side. Oh, now here, throw this way. Send me. Oh, I come under. Oh, wow. There's my standing center lock. Back into my gooseneck, my pistol grip, my two-finger lock, my chicken wing. Wow. You see what I mean? Into my hammer lock. Everything is there. But you have that initial movement. So he walks up and he grabs me first. Oh, wow, there it is. Now I go this side. Same thing. I bring him back up. Back to here. Pour the coffee over here. Yeah. Bring him back around. It's all there. But you have to get your imagination once you understand base. So here we go. One. Turn it over here like this. Now step in. Hook here. Look at that. Now, if I straighten out my arm, lift my elbow, I'm applying the shoulder lock and the wrist lock. Wow. You see that I'm doing it nice and slack? I get next to him today, it's going to be bad. I can leg sweep him. You know, I can do inside leg, outside leg, or I can drop to my knee. It'd be a real bad deal. Or I just take him off like that. You know. Off of that one little wrist lock. One. Kick him. Hit him if I want to. There it is. I can change you to a choke. Twist it. Wow. Nice. All right. Get some. Locks. All martial arts. In my opinion. All the same. What do you mean? Everybody wants to be different. It's just like music. There are no new notes. Same notes. That's all we have. Yeah, we hear different music all the time. Well, that sounds different. I like that. Hey, I just wrote a new song. Yeah, but you just change the notes around. You didn't make new notes. The problem with the untalented martial artist, he only knows the full note. He don't know how to do a half note. People think it's just one sound. The little half notes make up the difference from melodies and your variety. Okay? Now, I'm going to show you that I'm doing the exact same thing. Let's look at the wrist lock. See that? Boy grabs this side one. See the wrist lock? Is that not the lock? It's turned like that, right? So we think, well, this is the way you do an inside wrist lock. Well, that's because I happen to be on the inside. But I can do it from the outside. It becomes very, very fast and very, very effective. I told you later, you're grabbing a punch and doing a leverage is not going to work real good. But if he throws a jab at me and I'm able to block and catch like that, I watch immediately this hand slide down. Come in close to the camera. Watch his hand slide down. Now you tell me if there's any difference there than this. In your mind maybe, but because you're not educated. It's the same move. I just did it a different way. If I'm Chinese, it's a Chinese technique. If I'm Japanese, it's a Japanese technique. You know what I mean? I'm Texan, it's Texas technique. Rick Moneymaker does Virginia technique. Only Rick will add some electrical charges in there that make people explode. And I'm not kidding. You know, this later on this year, I'm going up to Myrtle Beach to the Dragon Society camp. I'll be honored to be able to teach here, but more importantly, I get to learn, you know, because the pressure point stuff, people laugh at the coup because they don't understand it. You know what I mean? They don't know how it's used. They know how to do this. It empowers what I'm doing here. So he's punching, and I'm blocking and catching. Right away, I pull. Hold up. When I pull this, look at this hand. See that? Now make a fist. If he makes a fist, no problem. When I squeeze right here, the hand opens anyway. Boom. Down he goes. And there it is. There's my technique. You see? So he's punching. Coming on, block it. One. Wow. Shit slides down. Now look. Pull. Look at that. Look at that. Now all I got to do, if I step back with this foot, there's my takedown. So it's the same move that we're doing. He grabs, you gotta go one, and you see, he grabs both hands. Let's go that way. Is that not the same look? Is that not the same lock? But I did it differently. Yeah. I can play more than one instrument, and I can also play the half notes. I can create music. Understand? So, when I go here, one, that's the same thing. I step in, I poured the tea from this side, or the coffee, or whatever I'm pouring. Now, on the chart there, it said footwork, which I just did. Then it said level change. Now, level change isn't done when you get ready, because now he's ready. So the first move, I'm already down below him. I inject into him, pour the tea. Wow. You see? Once you understand, it's really going to start to change things fast. So he punches one, pull, wow, there it is. I raise it up, pull down, I can hold it. If I don't want to take it down, I can actually do it again. That's easy. Punch, one, up, and trap him here. You see what I mean? But my objective is to get him down. So what I'm doing, I'm level change, right? Whoa, I'm moving up, step in, bang. There it is. I can follow up whatever I want to do. Slide into the locker. So many things you can do. All right? So, you notice the motion there. Look up in the hand. Two-hand grab. I reach under. I grab the thumb. Look at it. See where the thumb's pointing? Pull the teeth.
Oh, God.
I'd like you to do that. It feel good? Let's see the other hand. I'll just make it even. Come under. I grab the thumb. Now, I'm going to pour the teeth from one cup over here, the other cup over there. Wow. There it is. You see how simple that was? All right, pour some coffee.
I'm going to show a variation.
Everybody has names for it, and that's for the system. It's important for you to be able to follow it, to name it. You know, when I learned judo, everything was taught in Japanese. And as anybody knows me, I have enough trouble speaking English or Texan, much less Japanese. So, you know, Shimonagi to Umasi. I would just Tominagi. I would be murdered. Japanese go, no, that's not it. But I could do the move. You know? So, because of American, we try to use American words. This is called center lock. It's called wrap hand. And Aikido is Kaimikyo. There's so many different names. And there's many, many ways to do it. And I studied all four of those systems. And they all four work. You just have to find the one that fits you. Some make more sense for combat. Some make more sense for control. But they all work. Well, this is better than that. Well, it's because you're better at that, you know. Go get a really, really good Aikido guy and tell him it's not any good. He'll make you your butt to the ground, you understand? So it's a matter of your skill level of the art. But I'm gonna show a center lock here, stroke here, a cross grab. And all it is I'm going to bring my elbow in, look on my hand. Everybody wants to do all the thing out here, and in my opinion, that's not going to work because I feel that I'm getting out of town right away. So my first move, hold me tight. I can't move him until I move. Wow. Now, I'm going to wrap. Oh, this is a wrap hand. Now watch my fingers. One, two, three, four, five. See that? I'll just do this. There's slack in here right now. See that slack? Now watch when I, he'll tell you, it's wrapping in there. Now, Mr. Moneymaker and Mr. Muncie, in fact, all the Dragon Society guys, they do this sneaky. They go, pizzicato. Some people make, they grab this so much that they don't get around with such a big slap and they can't get their arm here. All the way up the toes are the same. I want him to be able to give, so I need to play. Okay. So one,
Here is the magic. So the patient's been a lot to get straight down. And it can be painful.
Okay.
But I'll tell you the magic that I
discovered. Walla J. told me the principle of this book, oh, it's fantastic. And all I've done is take this. Now, instead of going down, I'm going to take this and a corkscrew going under his arm. See that? Now, I'm doing it where you can see the motion of the arm, but I'm doing it without any pressure, which doesn't hurt. One. Down he goes. And a really good Aikido guy, he does that. You don't want any more. He can hold you to control you because it's a gentle art. Or he can go back to his roots of jiu-jitsu, where it came from, and break it. Or he can go further back, like 4,000 years. Sun Tzu is done like this. I break it. I'm not waiting for a tap. This becomes a fist, because when I do my hand like this, grab my fingers. Ah! Got it. A lot of styles do this. Now, like this, grab your fingers, it's a bad day for me. Here is a gentleman's way of doing it. Here's a soldier's way of doing it. Break it. I don't want to hold you long, I want to break it. You see what I mean? Now, same thing if you grab a straight grab. See this? Marry it to your chest. Wow, there it is. But this time as it comes up, there it is. You see that? Now, one of the worst things I know, oh wow, and I come in here and lock. Oh wow, this is bad. You see? This is a bad one right here. Now this will bring his head down, back at knee, whatever I want to do. Okay? Let's watch that again. One, striking, bend this. Oh, there he is. You see what I mean? That's his center lock, guys. That's all it is. But the more traditional one, you see more like this. That's cool. But the combat one is nice and tight. So if he grabs me straight grab, one. Well, see, I go this way. Oh, that's magic. You will not believe the difference it is. You see, let's say he's choking me. That's bad. That's real bad. Now watch me turn the fingers around. Now it's up under here. Wow, I can walk him. Play a finger lock. Take a quick one here. Pull it down. But this lock is very, very effective. Okay? He grabbed the two hands. I just need the one hand, remember? So let's review the center lock on the back. Here. Now if I want to shed it, punch it, there it is. But as soon as he grabs, wow. Whatever I mechanically want to do. Once you get it, one. Now, see this? That or the half notes put with the big notes. You don't walk like this. That's the big notes. You put a big note with a half note. See that? See that rolling? Now when he grabs me. Oh wow. Still on him, by the way. Oh wow. Back down. That's for combat. All right, one more time. Center lock. One. Wrap around. Who's going there? Who's one of our new students? Very, very strong. Okay, he grabbed me. I go here. And right away, he locks his arm. I'm not able to snake it. What you want to do is snake it in, but he's too strong. So, right away, I abandon that step to here. Wow. Push him down. You see what I mean? Now, there's many ways to make him bend that arm. I go to here, he does a bend, I can jack the twins, I can hit here, but I'm probably going to lose this grip. So, as soon as I see this, it's going to go straight. There's my lock there. You see what I mean? Then I can come back to the wrist lock, pull that key over here. You see what I mean? You see how they fit together? But I want you to realize, as soon as you feel that that's not going straight, no problem. Go ahead and use that. Or I can push it off and get whatever technique that I do that you do. But that's gonna happen sometimes. Wow. Now if I step in, pull that, it might work. But you don't have time to figure that out. It has to happen. just like that. As soon as I see it stop bending, I go to the straight lock. Maybe bring my leg over, lock it down, whatever. You know what I mean? Now roll, you're in bad shape. So I'm like, I can't roll anymore. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much. Now, Connor? This lock. One. Down. All I do is roll. You do that?
Yeah.
I can't roll anymore. Oops. There's your lock. There's an example. That's the same lock. That's a rolling wrist lock. You know, I said, well, why would you do something like that? Maybe I got live fire coming in. So I got to get out of the fire zone. I got multiple attackers. Boom, I disappear. I use the rolling technique, the ground technique. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Master Schaefer. Three. There it is. And then put it between your legs. Walk in. There's your lock right there. So there's all kinds of variations you can do. All right? Everybody one side? I feel 71 today, I tell you that. But for those of you who watch this tape, I hope you enjoy. Give you back a little something. Look at the principle of what I'm doing. I don't do it as well as I used to, but I think I can explain the principle to you real, real good. Get this base down. If you know one real wrist lock really good, suddenly they'll all come to you. Don't try to learn too many because you lose the focus of the one move. And remember, it's the footwork, the weight change, level change. Adapt to whatever's happening, and then take your best shot. Do what you do best, all right? Anyway, thank you very much, and hope you're around next year to show us something else, all right?